So we have one more unit of review, rational expressions and equations. We'll talk about those here today. One is just the basics. We talked about polynomials and what those look like. And rational expressions, looks something like, maybe an example would be 2x plus 4 over 3x squared minus 5x plus 6. So you have these two pieces. You definitely have this division sign. It's a ratio of two things. And then you have these two pieces, a polynomial in the numerator and a polynomial in the denominator. And that's what makes up a rational expression. So, and let's talk about the first thing that we want to know how to do is to simplify these into their lowest terms. So, for example, simplify12x minus 9y over 3x squared plus 3xy. Now, in order to simplify, one of the first things I need to do is factor. We'll factor first and then cancel. So, factoring the numerator, I think I can take out a 3, and I'm left with 4x minus 3y. In the denominator, I think I can take out a 3x, and I'm left with an x and plus y. And I want to cancel the pieces that are the same. In this case, I have a 3 in both the numerator and denominator, and that's it. This factor of 4x minus 3 isn't repeated in the denominator, and the other factors aren't repeated. So I get 4x minus 3y over x times x plus y. And depending on what you're doing, you might leave the denominator like this, or you might remultiply out. Adding rational expressions. So the example that we'll do, add 4 divided by x squared plus 5x plus 6 plus x minus 2 over x plus 3. So just like you would do if you were working with real, with numbers and fractions involving numbers, we need to get like denominators, get a common denominator, and to do that I need to factor. This first one factors 4, and x squared plus 5x plus 6 factors to be x plus 2 and x plus 3. Plus, and the second one is already in factored form, x plus 3. So the least common denominator should be x plus 2 and x plus 3. So I don't have to do anything to this first term, but I do have to multiply the second term by x plus 2 over x plus 2. So let me do that. The first term stays the same. 4 over x plus 2 times x plus 3 plus x minus 2 over x plus 3. And here's where I'm going to multiply. I'll show that. X plus 2 over x plus 2. I can't change anything, so multiplying by the same thing, numerator and denominator, is just like multiplying by 1. I'm changing the form of this second term, and this will get me into a common denominator. So when I do that, I get 4 over x plus 2 times x plus 3 plus x minus 2 times x plus 2 over x plus 3 times x plus 2. Now these might look different in the denominator, they're in a different order, but they're exactly the same. And now the next step is to go ahead and add these together. So I'm going to get a new sheet of paper. I want to combine them. So I get 4 plus x minus 2, x plus 2, over x plus 3, x plus 2. And then I just want to simplify. I have to multiply out in the numerator. X squared minus 2 and plus 2 cancel, so I get x squared minus 4, x plus 3, x plus 2. So I think I get x squared. Oops. This should be an x plus 2. That's it. Okay. I get x squared in the numerator, and x plus 3, and x plus 2 here. And I just want to make sure that that's completely simplified. I can't cancel, so this should be my final answer. Subtract should work the same way. I just need a common denominator. So I'll do this problem, subtract 4x plus 2. Divide by 3x plus 12 minus x minus 2 for x plus 4. So again, I factor the numerator, factor the denominator to see what a common denominator would be. And I see that my least common denominator is 3 times x plus 4. So I multiply the second one by 3 in the numerator and denominator. So I get 4x plus 2 over 3x plus 4 minus, and then I probably would go ahead and multiply this out, 3x minus 6, and 3x plus 4. So I'm going to go ahead and combine those into one fraction, minus 3x plus 6. Be sure to change those signs, 3 times x plus 4. Combine like terms in the numerator, and I get x plus 8 over 3 times x plus 4. And again, check to see if you can simplify, but this should be the final answer. Multiplying rational expressions is actually easier, multiplying and dividing, if you remember, than adding and subtracting. Multiply. And here's the problem that I have. X squared minus 4 over x times x squared minus 3x over x minus 2. So I want to go ahead and factor everything and cancel, and then I'll combine. So I'm going to factor the numerator. That's x. That's a difference of squares, x plus 2 over x minus 2. Over x. This has a greatest common factor. And then I can cross out or cancel anything that is in the numerator and denominator. So here's an x plus 2 and that cancels with that. The x's cancel and that should be it. So I get x plus 2, x minus 3, over 1, which we'll just simplify to be x plus 2, x minus 3. Division works very much the same. I just need to remember to divide like you would with fractions. So divide 1 over x squared minus 9 divided by 1 over x minus 3 squared. The first thing that I do in division is the keep change flip. Keep this fraction the same, change this to multiplication, and flip this second fraction. So I keep the 1 over x squared minus 9, change to a multiplication sign, and flip this so it's x minus 3 squared divided by 1. Now I'll factor This again is a difference of squares, 1 over x minus 3, x plus 3 times, and this is x minus 3 squared, still that's in factored form over 1. So then once I get this factored, I can cancel. This cancels and leaves 1x minus 3. I think that's all the cancellation. So I get x minus 3 over x plus 3 as my final solution. Solving rational equations. So an example. Solve y over 2 minus 4 over y is equal to negative 7 over 2. So when I talk about identifying rational equations and when you might want to use these techniques, a rational equation is any equation that involves fractions, either polynomial fractions or just regular fractions. Numerical fractions. If you want to simplify the equation from the beginning, the best way to do that is to multiply by the least common denominator. In this case, the least common denominator is 2y. If you do this correctly, it will get rid of all of your fractions for you, and then you can go forward from there. So I multiply everywhere by this 2y. Like there, minus 4 over y times 2y. Now, not 2y over 2y, just by 2y so that these things cancel. Okay? Now, so when you do that, you should get a lot of cancellation. For example, here in this first term, the 2's cancel, and I get y times y, which should leave me with y squared. In the second term, the y's cancel, and I get negative 4 times 2, which is minus 8. And in this last term, the 2's cancel, and I should be left with negative 7y. This is a quadratic equation, y squared, and I put the 7y on the left side, so I add 7y to both sides, and then solve by factoring. I get y plus 8 equals 0. And y minus 1 equals 0, and y is equal to negative 8, and y is equal to positive 1. You want to go back with rational equations and check this solution in this original equation and make sure that it still works, especially that it doesn't cause 0 in the denominator. So here, when you plug that back in, you should get, let's see, negative 8. Let's go down. So I'll rewrite the original equation, y over 2 minus 4 over y, negative 7 halves. And I plug in negative 8. Negative 8 halves. So this becomes a plus 1 half. And that it checks out. So it's a solution. You need to do the other solution as well, and I'll let you guys do that. That's y is equal to 1 to make sure that it's really a solution. Okay, that should be it for rational expressions and equations. Please let me know if you have any questions.